Hello everyone. So requests today, yes, I take requests. We're going to focus on the topic of dietary supplements. Although this request was specific to supplements for kids, it doesn't matter as the topic is the same regardless of the size of the human. So today we will look at what supplements are, who needs them, safety issues, and best practices when purchasing supplements. Welcome back. My name is Begoña. I am a nutritionist, dietitian, hoping to motivate you to take control of your health by becoming more informed each day. Be sure to subscribe to my channel to receive weekly nutrition and health information. If you are like most people, you have probably taken a supplement at some point in your life. I know I have. Over 70% of adults in the US take one form of supplement or another. And 1 in 3 children are also given daily supplements. The US Congress defines dietary supplements as follows: a product taken by mouth that contains a dietary ingredient intended to supplement the diet. They can be found as tablets, capsules, liquids, or powder form. Examples include vitamins and minerals, phytochemicals, herbs, botanicals, proteins, and probiotics. I mentioned that they must be taken by mouth because I have a nagging feeling that it may soon become a crucial part of the definition of a supplement. Let me explain. There's a newer trend you may have heard of called IV vitamin bars. IV as in intravenous, where you give them your arm and your money, and in return, they inject you with a cocktail of supplements that you have previously chosen from a menu without the need of a doctor checking if it's safe or even necessary. I have a lot of thoughts about this new trend, but since there isn't much science behind this fad, I will not humor anybody with my commentaries just yet. Suffice it to say that if you inject a cocktail of supplements into an arm, by definition, you are no longer taking supplements. So who is regulating these? Supplements are not intended to replace food, although many consumers often view them as substitutes for food and medications, giving us a false sense of security. To this day, there is no solid scientific evidence that proves that supplements are helpful to maintain or improve health. There is also no evidence that they help prevent, cure, or treat disease. Even though there is no substantiated proof that supplements work to make us healthier or prevent disease, people still buy them at incredible rates. The supplement industry continues to grow, and it's now a $56 billion industry. Can you imagine taking and paying for a vaccine or a medication that has no evidence that it works? So why don't we have scientific evidence proving that supplements help us live longer and healthier lives? Well, I'm going to try to explain this to you with a couple of examples. There's a phytochemical found in tomatoes and in most red and pink fruits. It is known as lycopene. Lycopene is a powerful antioxidant that has been found to have many benefits to health, including benefits to your heart, to improve the strength of your immune system, and to lower the risk of certain cancers. This phytochemical has been studied for over 70 years, and there are more than 2,000 peer-reviewed articles examining its health effects. So putting lycopene in a pill makes sense. However, study after study shows that lycopene supplements do not work and may worsen the symptoms of prostate cancer in men who already have the disease. The second example is that of beta-carotene, the plant form of vitamin A. We find this vitamin in fruits and vegetables of orange and deep green colors. Again and again, studies confirm that people eating lots of fruits and vegetables high in beta-carotene have lower risks of cancer. However, when beta-carotene is produced in a lab and made into a supplement, those benefits go away. In fact, in the case of beta-carotene, supplement companies raced to mimic its chemical structure to sell as an anti-cancer miracle. After consumers had bought these supplements, trials around the world had to be stopped as scientists found a 28% increase in lung cancer among smokers taking the supplement, compared with the placebo groups. Examples like these repeat themselves across the supplement industry. When comparing them to food, supplements simply cannot mimic or compete with the health benefits that come from eating food. The motive may not be so hard to understand. Take this garlic or an apple. Every single food is a complex system of chemicals that interact with each other in ways we can't grasp. When we isolate one or two nutrients from a food and copy their chemical structure in a lab, we are unable to duplicate all the reactions in that garlic or that apple or that tomato that are happening to make the lycopene and the beta carotene and the vitamin C and the fibers and carbohydrates and proteins all work together in synergy at the right time and the correct dosage. We simply cannot replicate this in a powder or a pill or two or 10. But there's still people that need dietary supplements. So who needs them? Supplements work really well to correct nutrient deficiencies. To know if you have a deficiency, go to your doctor and ask for a complete blood and urine analysis. If you find that you need to, then take a supplement until the deficiency is corrected and then stop taking the supplement. Last time I checked, who wants to take pills every day for the rest of their lives? It would be wise to figure out why you had the deficiency in the first place. For children, if you're concerned that your child is a picky eater and this may be getting in the way of their development, take them to their pediatrician. Have them get a blood test so you can have peace of mind. The American Academy of Pediatrics does not recommend supplements for children that are growing normally. There are a few other groups that may need supplements, including some pregnant women, someone that has undergone bariatric surgery, and people living with HIV. For the majority of people, however, there really is no reason to take a supplement. Are dietary supplements safe? Contrary to what you would think, supplements don't need approval from any government agency before they reach the shelves of our supermarket or pharmacy. When you walk into a GNC or the supplement aisle of your pharmacy, it makes sense to believe that everything in those shelves is safe to consume. This is far from the truth.
Say what?
We have to put all of our trust in the supplement companies, as 100% of the safety of the product is left in their hands. This lack of regulatory standards is the reason why supplement companies have been booming for decades and why supplements have become a common part of living healthy. The Food and Drug Administration has tried to regulate supplements as drugs for decades. Sadly, every piece of legislation that has been passed regarding supplements has been not to regulate, but to deregulate the supplement industry. And to give anybody without any background in medicine or pharmacology, chemistry or nutrition, anybody at all, the ability to produce dietary supplements without having to prove their quality and safety before being sold. Can you imagine leaving your car to be repaired by someone with no knowledge or background of automobiles? When Frontline's 2016 documentary, Supplements and Safety, was aired, supplement sales were over $30 billion a year. It is projected that supplement sales will reach $118 billion by the year 2027. I have added a link to this documentary, and I do suggest that you watch it. For the past four decades, the FDA has tried to regulate supplements before they make it to the market. And at every step, they have been blocked by the heavy lobbying of the supplement industry. To this day, the only way that the FDA can get a supplement out of the market is if there are claims from the public that the supplement is dangerous to health. This means that people have to get very sick before the FDA has enough evidence to remove a supplement from the market. Sadly, this has been too late for many people who have needed organ transplants or died from taking certain supplements, some of which could be in your home right now. The problem gets bigger Not only supplements do not have to be checked for safety before making it into your grocery bag, the label is also not checked for accuracy, potency, or contamination. So you may get less or more milligrams or micrograms of any of the ingredients listed on the supplement label. Toxicity from overconcentration of a nutrient can have detrimental health effects, as symptoms can begin to develop silently, and by the time you realize there's something wrong, it may be too late to reverse the damage. Other supplements may have 0 milligrams of the nutrient you are buying, and any of them may be contaminated at any time with heavy metals like lead, arsenic, and mercury, and even anabolic steroids and pesticides. This problem will persist until the supplement industry is required by law and demanded by consumers to prove that their product is safe before it can make it to the market. If they stand behind their product, why can they prove quality, safety, potency, and accuracy before it's sold to us? In the meantime, buyer beware. Only take supplements if you have a proven need for them. If your child is growing normally, stop worrying. And if you do need a supplement, only take supplements that have been verified by one of 3 highly regarded independent laboratories: the US Pharmacopoeia, NSF International, and ConsumerLabs.com. These laboratories make thorough, unbiased, and unannounced random assessments of products. If the supplement passes their rigorous tests that check for purity, quality, potency, and adulteration, then you will see one of these 3 seals on the bottles. Purchase those, again, only if you absolutely need them. At the end of the day, the supplement industry is still lacking the most basic requests from science and consumers. Provide us with solid proof that getting nutrients from supplements is at least the same, if not superior, to getting nutrients from food. As of now, getting nutrients from food is the best place where to find your nutrients. Maybe someday we will be able to have supplements replace foods. But until then, let's enjoy chewing food like we have for generations. I hope that this information was helpful. Don't forget to subscribe and share this video. The more we learn, the more power we have to make educated choices. Until next time, cheers to your health.